Hello, welcome to Eyes in Japan. Let's go for a drive in Japan today. In the background, I'll be playing a live radio from London. It's the Adventist Radio London. Let's enjoy this journey in Japan today.
Subject, that lesson a day, that everyone happens repeatedly or experiences that can be traumatic, you know, and I'm not using that word lightly because trauma has a massive scope from the things that we think about, huge traumas of childhood, all the way through to stress, you know, that you repeatedly experience.
That's really important to know.
Absolutely. You know, repeated stress, things that aren't dealt with, can cause traumatic impact on you. Those rejects were definitely doing something to my mind. You know, they were almost making me, whilst it definitely wasn't an element of it that was helping me to grow, which I definitely see now, at the time, it just felt as though nothing was going right.
Right.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I couldn't see the wood for the trees. I couldn't see what impact I was making, you know, and I think that sometimes when we have these experiences, we are not able to really reflect effectively because all we can see is the way we feel.
Yeah.
We feel rejected. We feel like we're not making an impact. Actually, if we were to talk to someone else, perhaps, and get some perspective, maybe we would actually realize that we are making an impact. And maybe we'd also realize that rejection doesn't mean that you're not making an impact.
Oh, that's good. Rejection doesn't mean that you're not making an impact.
Right.
Yeah, that's really good. So you had personal experience then of some of the mental and emotional side effects of facing these barriers. How can we overcome those barriers? How can we improve our mental and emotional health when we're facing these kinds of issues?
I mean, that's a huge question, and I think there are many answers to that question, but I would say that one of the fundamental things I've learned is that you cannot get through this life alone. You as a, whoever you are, you need support. And the truth about it is God created us in a community. He created us with family, he created us with friends, but the relationships are not just about having those just jovial, fun, happy conversations all the time, you know. These relationships are actually about going deeper and really being vulnerable with one another. And I think one of the first steps to coping and overcoming with these things is to establish a relationship with someone that you can trust, that you respect, and one of those you're going to keep your conversation confidential, but you can really be honest with about what you're going through. It doesn't matter how triggering you may feel that thing is, you have to talk to someone. You just need somebody. And one of the things I would say is sometimes as Christians, we can think that there's some kind of something wrong about talking to someone, that we should only ever take to God.
Right. Praying is enough.
Praying is just enough. The reality of the fact is, Jesus is our perfect example. Okay? Jesus is our perfect example. But even he, in addition to his close relationship with God, he needed his disciples. Do you remember when he went away to pray before he was in, when he was in the Garden of Gethsemane, and he asked the disciples to pray?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. There are examples throughout scripture, not just of Jesus, but of others who needed to rely on others. And I think we should just remember that when God created us as God's minds, we need those around us. But I have to rely on myself all the time because my tendency, you know, is just with these same perfectionism, fear of rejection, all these things, is to want to deal with issues alone. we don't know what we're telling ourselves. And one of the best ways to, I say, is to understand better what your thoughts are, is to find an opportunity, ideally when you are in a time of heightened emotion, you're stressed or you're upset, but in that time you want to take a pen and paper and you want to write down some of the things you're experiencing, some of the thoughts that you're having. And obviously it's not something just to do arbitrarily, and I'm saying this like as a clinician or a, so I'm saying this purely just I guess as something that I've done, I find has been helpful. So
write poetry, some people do, you know, other
sometimes I might write something or say something that's supposed to be for another person, and it ends up being exactly what I needed to hear in the moment. It's crazy.
It's amazing. It's amazing. And so many songs that I've written, you know, in those times when I've been struggling with fear, or, you know, wanting to hide away, or whatever those things are, and God has just given me something that's told me what He thinks about me and what He wants to do with me, and that really powerful for healing. So, you know, I really encourage those listening, if you struggle with mental health, you know, reach out to someone. And I'd encourage you to find support with your thoughts, definitely. And then definitely use what you have. You've got a story, and it might not be that, you know, you see yourself as a songwriter or a writer. You've got something else. You've got something unique to you. And that thing is going to change the world. You have to believe that God gave it to you to change the world around you. So find out what that is and start using that.
I love that. That's so encouraging. Coming back to your story, Charlotte, as you've been learning these things, sharing these things, and setting up Soul First Music and coaching, what have you learned about God on your journey?
So many things. I mean, some of which I've touched on, but I'd say one of the major things that I have learned is that humility is not what I perhaps thought it was when I was growing up. I think I had a misconception that humility was about hiding away. Humility was about not shining as brightly as you can, you know, minimizing your shine. Humility was about, you know, if somebody asks you certain things about what you do, or if you're a singer, or if you're whatever, that you kind of say, oh, kinda, not really. You know, that was something I wrongly thought was actually false humility, now I know. But at the time, I thought that that was what humility was. And as I've grown, what I've learned is that truly humility is about accepting and appreciating and using what you've been given to serve others. That's what it's all about. It's the serving of others that is the element of what humility is. And Jesus, again, is our perfect example of that. He used everything he was given. He used his gifts, you could say, as much as he possibly could. And every opportunity, all the time, you know, he was balanced. He didn't use, you know, he knew when to go away and to take some time out. But he used his opportunities to serve. And that's what we have learned about God. That God is not that person up there that's kind of trying to catch me out. Trying to kind of say, oh, look, you're proud that you're doing that. No, actually, God is like, come on, Charlotte, I want to use you. Come to me as you are. And I will show you my work. And yes, you're going to make mistakes, but I love you, and I will work with you through those and still use you anyway. So that's what I've learned about God. I think another thing that I've learned about God is that He is.
Now that's something I hear Christians say a lot, so I'm really interested in your take. What do you mean God is enough?
I'd say God is enough. I'm talking about the fact that as much as I want to do and serve God and do my best, right? The reality of the fact is this. I have been born in sin and shaped in sin. God knew that when he made me. That, and whilst he is making me into the person I should be, and even beyond that, because again, it's sometimes we think we're going to get to this place where we work with God, and we're going to get to this place where actually his grace is not going to be sufficient, because we'll have gotten there ourselves.
I've got it now, God, thank you.
Yeah, I've got it sorted now, you know, I don't need to raise the righteousness anymore, you know, it's not that, like, God is enough cover you at every level, from your what you think is your deepest, darkest sin to your what you think is maybe your lightest sin. I mean, we know it's all sin, but the truth is God is enough to cover you. It's not to say, for example, that you know you've had a relationship with God, you've been walking with him, and is enough to cover you. And it's just important that I have to remind myself that constantly. It's not about what I can do, and it's not about proving myself to God or being a, you know, being this person that I'm going to say, yes, Charlotte, you're good enough for me. No, actually, he's good enough. And that's why I'm picking up for him too.
That's really beautiful. Charlotte, thank you so much for sharing from your journey, from your learning with us this morning. Where can the listener connect with you if they want to find out more about your coaching, your music? How best can they get in contact?
Yeah. Okay, so the best place to find me in terms of the coaching is on Facebook. We do have a website we're working on, but it's not live yet.
Okay.
So probably you'll find out when that goes live on the Facebook page. So the Facebook page is facebook.com/soulthirstministries. That's facebook.com/soulthirstministries. And from there, you can also find the music page, which is facebook.com/soulthirstmusic. I think if you start off with the coaching page, you'll be able to find, there are posts that every now and then I put on the music page as well.
That's great.
And so that's progress. I'd love to have an email address. So if you are interested in learning more about the coaching, perhaps yourself, perhaps a child, I work with young people from as young as 16 years old, all the way up to however young you feel you are. And you know, I've got clients I've had that are in their 40s and on. So it, you know, there's not a limit to that sense. So I tend to work more with the 16 to 25 year old age group. You know, you might have something you really want to pursue, and you think perhaps working with someone like myself might be supportive. So do reach out. The email is soulthirstministries@gmail.com. soulthirstministries@gmail.com, and I'll get straight back to you.
That's wonderful. Charlotte, thank you so much. I've really enjoyed speaking with you, and I pray that God will continue to bless the really important work that you're doing.
Thank you so much, Annette. It's been a blessing.
Thank you.
Do you go back there to abandon me? And Lord, I need you whisper prayers. Remember the moment you let Jesus in.
You have arrived at Yokohama Central Station. I hope you had enjoyed the ride with us today.